Hi, I'm Holly.
And I'm Rebecca, the gardener here at Ethereum College. This project started just about a year ago exactly. We have laid down compost and are growing veggies with the kids and the community to grow food for everyone, I guess. To get classes out, to get some learning in the garden, and get some food back in with the kids and get them excited about fresh produce. Maybe get them gardening at home. Some of the goals are to get kids outside, to get them out of the classroom, engaging sort of with their local spaces.
And their land.
Yeah.
And the land that the school's on. Kids really love coming out to the gardens. They love telling us about all the vegetables they know and recognize, and they love eating weeds, and they love telling us about the plants that their parents grow and maybe their grandparents grow. They don't all have home gardens, so it's cool to hear that even though they don't, they do know a lot about gardening, and they have tips and tricks that they teach us about gardening, which has been really cool.
A lot of students have really gotten into kale chips this past year, which has been quite a surprise because lots of people are sort of wary of kale.
Most of the kids say, "Kale, this is what cows eat," from their parents' farms.
But then we'll go in and we'll make kale chips with them, and they'll take them out like little waiters and waitresses and serve staff kale chips and really hustle the kale chips, which has been cool to see. And they'll come out and they'll take kale and they'll eat it fresh, and they'll come out and they'll pick an onion and they'll eat it fresh, and they're sort of willing to try anything because this is sort of a more wild space that they can express themselves in and just do whatever they want in. So we let them feel a little bit rebellious, even though it's sort of our intent, but they feel like they're breaking rules by pulling a carrot out or by snapping off a kale leaf or sneaking away and eating an onion, which is pretty funny to see. And we're working on developing some curriculum with the teachers so that teachers don't have to feel like they're responsible for
learning a whole new subject.
Right. So they can just bring their classroom and have a set. They know what they're doing out here, so we can get more classrooms and more curriculum-based learning out here.
And that's in all subjects, like English. The English kids are coming out to do oral histories of local gardeners in the area and all this land.
The math class came out and did their whole measurement unit out here. So they did volume and area and rate of water flow. So that was great because they felt like their project was really useful to what we're doing here.
Which it was. It was awesome.
Yeah. And the art class is going to come and sort of do
this
study of a plant from seed to fruit or flower.
And save the seeds as well. So yeah, we're trying to integrate all the different classes with the garden, not just teaching how to grow food, but also teaching how food has been a part of our history and a part of our language and our geography and yeah, everything. Environment, Southland.